Hey, what's up guys? It's the Fruity Tangerine 17, and well, welcome back to the next part of Let's Play Spyro 4 Enter the Dragonfly Semi-Blind. Now you might be asking yourself, Fruity, whatever are you doing in the Dragonfly Dojo again after the ridiculous glitchiness that was last time where I couldn't get that last Dragonfly? Well, I'll tell you what, good sirs and madams, I am going to be attempting something new in order to try and get this Dragonfly. So, first things first, we're gonna talk to this dragon. Blah, 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 don't even care what he has to say. Let's freeze him. Let's get up here and free this kite. And hopefully, something should happen. This doesn't look right to me. Because remember the first time when I did this challenge, there was like a number in the corner, a number of kites. It went 210, even though it should have been 3210. And basically what I've done is I've actually reloaded an old save state from before I played Honey Marsh, which was the most recent save state I had. And I was hoping to replicate this again by having that counter in the corner again, but even reloading an old save state, it hasn't made it appear, and I'm not sure why, because that's what I suspect. Because I don't know, it was on start on 2, so if I only rescued 2 kites, would that give me the Dragonfly? Because it doesn't seem to be working this time. Let's just talk to him and see what he says. Oh, wait. Thanks. I think it might have worked. I think it might have worked, because last time I tried to talk to these guys, they wouldn't talk to me, would they? So even if the counter isn't there, it looks like this might be working. If it does work, I have no idea what glitched out before. I really don't. It might have just been up to random chance, in all honesty. It really must. The annoying thing about this is I'm going to have to go replay Honey Marsh and Thieves Den and 100% complete those levels again. My god, at this point, there are more levels in this game I've had to complete twice than there are levels I haven't had to complete twice. And let's all try and forget about Luau Island, which I've completed 3 times so far in this Let's Play. Again, you only saw one of each of those playthroughs on screen. This is me off screen, stupid shenanigans happening. You know, when I was switching from the PS2 to the GameCube versions of the game and whatnot. And now this kite ridiculousness. It's all insane. It's honestly insane. Wait, oh, there's a counter. What the hell? The counter just suddenly showed up now. I don't get it. This game, I don't know what the hell happened before. I really don't. But it looks like now they're actually giving me the dialogue I deserve, which is brilliant. Yep, blah blah blah, go save kites. Man, this is, god, this has definitely been the most annoying Dragonfly challenge in the game because of its glitchiness causing me to have to replay 2 more levels again. Not that I'll complain too much. Honey Marsh and Thieves Den were both fantastically fun levels. Like, again, generally speaking, I think the levels of this game have gotten better towards the end. You know, Cloud9, Monkey Monastery. Honey Marsh isn't quite as good as those 2, but it's still pretty great. Thieves Den's fantastic. I don't know. Regardless of the fact that it's still kind of irritating to have to replay 2 old levels just for the sake of 1 glitchy Dragonfly in a completely separate level. Should have been keeping more track of my save states, putting 1 down after finishing every level and whatnot, then I probably wouldn't be in this mess, but hey, this is what the cards have dealt me, and this is what I shall have to deal with. deal. Get it? Yeah, real funny. Alright, let's talk to this last guy and hopefully get our Dragonfly. Hopefully, you know, fingers crossed. I've literally got my fingers crossed right now. I'm gonna try and play the game with my fingers crossed. Oh my god, this is actually surprisingly hard. Okay, we're not gonna try playing the game with fingers crossed. There we go, 0. This should work. Please work. I'm begging you, game. I'm begging you. Please. For my sake. For my sake! Come on! Give it to me, baby! Give it to me!
Thanks so much, Mr. Spyro! I've been looking for this kite all summer!
Yep. Yeah, blah, 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 blah. Baby Dragonfly! Yes! And it's a blue one, of course it is.
Hey, it's
Mooney. 10 out of 10. Oh. Level complete. Bloody brilliant. I have no idea what the hell that glitch was earlier, but it's all over now. It's all over. Mooney. Like, he's mooning me, because that's exactly what he did. He was pretty much laughing in my face, like, ha ha ha, you can't get me, I'm just gonna be glitchy, and, you know, gonna be completely unobtainable without having to reload an old save state, and now having to replay 2 entire levels to get back up to where you were. Ho 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 ho, ho ho ho, so funny, Mooney, my absolute favorite Dragonfly, that one. My absolute favorite Dragonfly. And we are back. Oh, as you can see looking at our atlas here, there it is, 10 out of 10 for Dragonfly Dojo. Let's go to it. Where is it? Baby dragons, screw the baby dragons. But there you go, it's done. I had to go back and I had to recomplete all of Honey Marsh and Thieves' Den. As you can see, it's now done. And some extra insights, I must say. That tank mission in Honey Marsh, I had a lot more trouble with it the second time. I don't know what's up with that. That was pretty annoying. And then the bloody speedway race, that now that it's stopped being glitchy, is actually quite legitimately difficult in Thieves' Den. And the platform challenge is still really fun. I'll say that in Thieves' Den. Definitely very epic. It's kind of good to be able to replay these levels at least once throughout the Blind Let's Play. Even if it does get kind of tedious and irritating, it does enable me to, you know, garner new perspectives on the levels that I didn't quite get the first time. I had to go through Thieves' Den like twice looking for one missing red gem. It was pretty annoying because that level is very huge. It was definitely less enjoyable the second time, but I think I'd still really enjoy it if I just had, you know, a bit of a longer break between runs through the level. I mean, I guess that goes for every level, doesn't it? But anyways, with that, all we have left is the final level, Jurassic Jungle. 600 gems, the least in the game, funnily enough. So we've got to jump in there and hopefully unlock the final boss. Not gonna lie, when I was looking at some Speedway videos for Thieves' Den, Oasis Speedway, because I was struggling with that race, I saw in the YouTube recommended videos something called a lava slide. Now, I don't know about you, but the slides in Monkey Monastery and the slide in Honey Marsh are definitely not a lava slide, so I'm anticipating another slide in this level, which gets me very, very excited. It also gets me a bit disappointed that Thieves' Den is the only level out of the latter four levels of the game without a slide. Kind of pisses me off. I don't know. I feel like every level kind of deserves a slide, to be honest. They are really fun, I must say. They really are. Anyway, all we have to do is walk on in, I believe. Yep, there we go, and we're heading into the level, Jurassic Jungle. Let's hope it's a good one. Whoa, what is this? Some kind of warp ball. I'm using the wing shield. This looks interesting. This is looks way too futury and all that for Jurassic Jungle. Like, what even? I don't know. Let's see what the level is all about, and hopefully it's all about being awesome, because we really do want this game to go out on a high note, don't we? We really, really do. I do not doubt that will be the case. Come on, you can't make your last level not be awesome. Come on, come on. Come off it, bro. Alright, loading in. Alright, I've never seen this level before, ever, so this is definitely interesting. Is that breakable? Looks breakable. Wow, what is this? Alright, let's talk to this guy. What's he gonna say? His level looks cool. Just wanna say that right now.
Aha, Spyro! The R1000 and the TRX-1000s have escaped from that inescapable...
inescapable.
...and are running amok through the jungle. Please stop them before they destroy the rest of the science labs and all of our research!
They've escaped from their inescapable cages.
No problem. But say, what's a R1000 something something?
Well, to put it in simplified terms that even a dragon can understand...
Racist.
They're mechanically enhanced, nanotech propulsion-oriented riptox, which we've been working on here in our labs. Quite the state-of-the-art, I might add. But very edgy.
But very edgy. This isn't even written out very edgy on the text here. This is like an extra add-on at the end. They're very edgy.
Oh, really? And how exactly would I go about destroying these things?
Oh, really?
Well, we did find a flaw in the R1000 models when they were exposed to sub-zero temperatures. Perhaps that information will come in useful.
All right, ice breath.
No problem. I have just the right breath to chill them out.
Now you're just making the hint way too blatant, game.
Great! On the other hand, the T-Rex-1000s are quite vulnerable to electricity. Yet we've not been able to get close enough to them to zap them with an electrical charge.
Well, that dialogue went on longer than most dialogues do, but hey, whatever. Use ice or electric breath, I guess. Little random cage here. Guess this is where one of the 1000s were kept, whatever they called. Was it R1000? I think it was. Also, what was with that racist in the dragons? Like, I'll put it in terms even a dragon can understand. Racist pig. Seriously, look at this guy. Look at this dick right here. Disgust me. Alright, so are these the guys I have to freeze or what? Well, it seemed to work. Oh, there's a number in the corner. Apparently, there's a certain number of them I have to kill. Love those electric fences. They look cool. Just want to put that out there right now. Oh boy, stop it. Alright, I'm guessing those guys then. Yep, yep, that's how we do it. That's how we do it. Freezing them with ice breath. I'm loving the aesthetic of this level. I like the darker greens. I think I mentioned this earlier. Like, same as with the grass in the home world. But, oh my goodness, this is the nighttime setting too. And look at that lava volcano. Oh, this looks awesome. Honestly, this level's not disappointing me so far. I'm gonna say that much. This level is most definitely not disappointing me so far. No siree. Oh, look, a yellow gem. How interesting. Is it worth 25? This level only has 600 gems. We can't afford to be throwing about 25s willy-nilly. Oh, game, please. Some tall grass. Is there anything in the tall grass? No, not really. It's just sort of there for decoration. I can appreciate that. And it also looks like we're going to go into a temple here, which is definitely fascinating. Whatever this level's doing with itself, I very much like it thus far. And I'm definitely looking forward to that lava slide. Presuming there is one, which, yeah, I'm kind of certain there is. I mean, I saw that video. It said lava slide. I'm looking forward to it. Ooh, there's another chest over here. I wonder what the other challenge could be, though. And there is also a locked chest here. Literally, all four of the latter four levels of the game have had chests. Monkey Monastery, Honey Marsh, Thieves' Den, and now Jurassic Jungle. It's interesting how they've done that. They've decided, you know, let's start introducing these chests. Because I guess there's something intrinsically tricky about them that they had to wait till their levels to introduce. Not really, but whatever. Now, I'm kind of curious. Is there anything around here? Yes, there is. You thought you could hide from me. But no, you could not. Like how they just put this lava pool in front of their temple. Like, you know, we definitely don't want anyone in here. Let's just put a giant lava pool right in front of it. But also put a floating platform on it so anyone that can, you know, glide can get in. Oh, that was bad. Anyways, we're now heading into the interior. Ooh, that doesn't look good. Get him before he shoots me with the stupid lasers. Sharks with freaking laser beams on their heads. Okay, they're not sharks, but I wanted to make that reference anyway. and I can't believe I got hit twice there as well. That was really pathetic. Now I'm going to have to find some fodder or get a checkpoint and kill myself. What's this guy got to say? Anything interesting? Oh, Sparks is back. What the hell? Professor Copeland.
Still fresh 3 days. They're following us. It's Spyro. I've been studying this temple, and it's quite fascinating.
Oh yeah? How so?
Spyro is so sarcastic.
These strange drawings on the walls are a clue to something hidden away in this temple. But I can't quite decipher them yet.
So that's why we have Sparks back, because he was needed for the cutscene. Wow. I wonder if we get to keep him. That would be amazing.
Yes, and from what I have been able to decipher, it seems that the gems on the statues inside react to heat. Perhaps you can figure out the rest, Spyro.
Well, obviously, I have to flame them. Also, I'd like to point out how his name is Professor Copeland, as in Stuart Copeland, the composer for this game and the first three Spyro games. I love that. That reference. I mean, it's got to be a reference. Come on, Copeland's not that common of a name. I don't think I've heard many people that have the name Copeland. And yeah, I got killed. Nice job. Nice performance, that one. I'm just saying, nice performance. Oh god, I'm back at the start of the freaking level. What the hell? Come on, guys. Come on. What's up with that? Come off it. Oh well, I guess it's not that far to run back, considering all the enemies seem to have despawned and so on and so forth, etc. Hopefully it isn't too annoying to have to backtrack to that chest later once I find the key. Hopefully there's, like, you know, a circular way back to the start. But there's been that for pretty much every level in the game so far, so I don't know why there wouldn't be this level. How did I miss that gem? What the hell? It must have dropped from the enemy and I didn't see it. That's got me a little bit on my guard about getting gems from other guys. Also, you know, shout out to the fact that Sparks had to be in that cutscene, so he spawned, and then the moment the cutscene was over, he went away. That's pretty funny, I must say. It's pretty funny. Okay, now this time, don't miss a gem. Yeah, there you go. It takes it a while for it to drop. It's made me wonder if I've missed any other gems from those guys, but I would have seen them on the way back, so I guess not. Now, there were some enemies over here. Let's take care of them. Bam. Bam. I'm gonna have a little look around this room. This looks cool. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Look at that statue and everything. This is an awesome level. Really like it. And again, I've legit never played this level before, ever. This is completely blind. Because Thieves' Den was the furthest I ever got back in the day, years ago. Not that I really remembered anything about Thieves' Den anyways, so that level was pretty much blind anyways. Pretty much 100% blind. I mean, I pretty much knew nothing about it except that it was set in a cave and it had thieves. That's pretty much all I knew going into Thieves' Den in the episode before last. This level, I knew nothing, but I could pretty much guess as much, you know. Jurassic Jungle, obviously it's set in a jungle. I didn't know it would have this much emphasis on temples, though, because, you know, the temple seems to be the big part of this level. Just going into it fairly early, and now we're doing all this platforming around and stuff. It's definitely interesting, though. I reckon, you know, you want to vary it. You don't want it to just be a jungle, because, yeah, I don't know, that could be a bit dull. You know, got this temple up in here. I do hope we go back into the jungle, though, you know, we get to have some proper gameplay going on in there. Which we probably will. Anyways, Dragonfly. Let's get him. Yeah, there we go. Doompa?
Hey, it's Doompa.
That's a weird name. Well, then again, we've had a lot of weird names. And it was a green one. No blue one for once. I am still going to do an official count on the colors of the Dragonflies. You know, looking at, like, walkthroughs online and stuff, seeing what colors they all are. I'm going to do a tally and then show that off in the next episode before we do the final boss. That's going to be brilliant. Now, wait a minute. Was there something down there? I swear I saw something. Oh, yes, indeed. I'm wise to your shenanigans, game. Whoa, camera, work with me. I also see gems down here, too. Oh, the key! Lovely. Well, got that earlier than expected. I don't think I want to go back now. I think, you know, once I've done the main part of the level, I'll loop back around and go do it, and that's probably the best way. Is there any... No, there is no easy way back up. Just gotta climb up the ladder manually again. Well, you know, it's not that big of a deal. Not that big of a deal, in all honesty. It doesn't take that long. I'm liking the sort of mossy, cobbled look of the floor here. That's an interesting texture. They definitely got a good variety of textures in this temple. I don't know, I feel like maybe they spent more time in this level than some other ones. I don't know. Possibly. I feel like they actually spent a fair bit of time on all the levels of this game, considering there is only 8 of them. It's just they didn't have enough time to, you know, refine them to the degree they would have, you know? I still wish they had to put more levels in the game, though, than just the 8, even if the 8 levels are definitely bigger than the ones in the first 3 Spyro games. That much is certain. In a way, they're also sort of simpler, though, because you don't have any gems in the side areas like you do in Spyro 3. Then again, that was always kind of annoying, you know? Well, you know, where am I missing gems? They could be in the side areas. That was definitely annoying. And look at this. Rope bridge over a huge lava pool. This is so cool, this level, honestly. Honestly. Not gonna lie. Alright, there we go. Get our green gem. I think they always drop green gems. At least all of them have thus far. Hopefully I'm not missing anything. I feel like I could be, you know, missing some side path or something. Got the lava going into the temple now. Red gems to collect. Appropriate coloration, you know, red gems for the lava room. Oh, looks like we're going out of the temple and back into the jungle. Nice. This looks really cool. I'm just gonna make sure I check around, and of course I should have, because there are baskets over here. Yeah, what's the point of this little platform? You can sort of see off into the distance. That reminds me of a skybox from one of the first 3 Spyro games, you know, just sort of generic, untextured mountains with sky, and yet, despite that, it looks fantastic, just because I just love the simplicity and the coloration, you know? Those green hills, the blue sky, dark blue sky. I just love the aesthetic, the dark green, the molten red lava, the nighttime sky. I like the darker colors. In terms of aesthetic palettes, I really adore darker colors, but that still exude a certain vibrance of color, you know? The way we have this dark greens and dark reds, but they really pop out and contrast against each other well, and then the blue sky backdrop as well. It's a really wonderful looking level. I mean, Thieves' Den was great looking too, but I think this is probably better, this one. This is probably my favorite looking level in the game so far, I want to say. In terms of gameplay, I can't definitively say it's my favorite level thus far, but I guess I'll have to make that decision once I've actually finished the level. Now, I noticed there was an area back there I could have gone to. I don't know if I want to do that now, or is that something I want to save for later? I'm just going to have a bit of a quick look. Bit of a quick gander. Is it just those vases? Is there anything else going on down there? No, it looks like there's other stuff going on down there. I think I will glide over there. Alright, now, let's see. There seems to be a grassy plot. Oh, there's a challenge portal over there, okay. Is there anything around here? Oh, there's a ladder. Is this just to get back up to the top level, though? I'd best investigate either way. I'd best. Yeah, okay, that's just all this is, just to get back up the top. That's fair enough. That's definitely fair enough. Let's just run along here and grab these main gems. So it looks like I should have done this area, because it just seems to be a little dead-end place. I thought there might be, like, some whole exploratory thing down here. Oh, it looks like we have an ice challenge gate. I think that's ice. I mean, it's blue, so... And it makes sense, because we've been using ice breath a lot in this level. Anyways, it's gonna grab these gems up first. Hopefully the challenge isn't too tricky for me. Hopefully, you know, you would hope that. You really would, wouldn't you? You know, I think I might actually do challenge portal first. I mean, why not? Why not? We'll come back, do that ice breath challenge at the end. Sounds like fun. Sounds like an absolute hoot. Really does. 350 gems. We're already over halfway through gems. It actually kind of scares me a little bit. I don't want this level to be too short, because I really am very much enjoying it. Very much. Alright, what is this all about?
My calculations indicate that this volcano is about to explode. Slide down to the bottom before it's too late, and don't worry about me. Save yourself.
Heroic sacrifice, except he doesn't sound too enthusiastic about it, do you, Professor Squeak? Anyway, apparently this is the slide. Yes, fist pump, axie fist pumping IRL right now, mate. Oh, it's not even explaining, like, the controls or anything anymore. They know we're familiar with the slide by now. They know we love it. It's tried and true. Let's go. Come on. How awesome is this going to be? Is it going to be even awesome than both the previous slides? I hope so. Oh, wow. We're like sliding down the side of a volcano. This looks awesome. Aesthetically, I love this. Again, like the main level. Oh, my God. It's like we're in... But the mountain setting, because the main level Jurassic Jungle doesn't seem that much of a mountain setting, but this is a proper mountain volcano setting, reminiscent of Monkey Monastery even, but I like lava aesthetics more than ice ones, at least with mountains, at the very least, so this is definitely cooler. Oh, I got hit. Does that actually damage me, or does it just do anything? I don't know. Whoa, careful, do not want to go in that lava. I'm presuming if I fall in the lava, it's a one-hit kill. Ah! Off the edge, didn't see it. Did not see it. That's okay. We'll give it another attempt. This music's pretty cool too. It's got that guitar going on. Wailing on that guitar, are you, Mr. Copeland? Yeah, look at those mountains, that mysterious fog out there. That's one of another reasons I like the sort of untextured basic skyboxes you've got in Spyro 1 through 3, and even in this game as well. They just have a certain mysterious to it, you know, a certain mystique, which I very much enjoy. Man, this is definitely very odd music, at least for the soundtrack we've had thus far in the game. It definitely feels very different, but I very much enjoy it, I must say. It's definitely a great song. Oh, we're gonna have a challenging room here. Gotta jump across all these different platforms. This is definitely seems to be the trickiest slide thus far, although we don't have to do that whole saving time by going through flags thing we had to do back in the monastery. Careful. Ooh. Ah! Adding some organ to the music now, I see. Staying true to your Spyro music origins, I see, Copeland. Touché, my friend, touché. we're coming out again. We're going into the jungle proper, it looks. Got some trees going on now. I guess we've shifted down from that mountain setting as we've descended down the side. Oh, look at these pillars. They look nice. And also, what are with these like little blue flames on the side? I'm really not sure what they are. Oh, gods, don't fall. It's a long way back to the start if I fall. No! I think that was the end. I think that was the end right there. Oh, that's tragic. That is truly tragic. It's a long slide. I think this is the longest slide thus far, because Monkey Monastery one was actually pretty short. You just had to do it twice. The Honey Marsh one was quite long, but I don't think it was as long as this one is. This is definitely a lengthy slide, and I'm loving it. I'm absolutely loving it. They have not disappointed with this final level thus far. No sorry, they have not disappointed. This is fantastic. The only level in the game I'm truly 100% blind with, and it's just being fantastic, which I'm just adoring. I really am. I'm still not sure what the point of the boulders is, though. I mean, that was a stupid failure. That was a really stupid failure. But yeah, the boulders, they don't damage you, they just slow you down, so... And we're not racing into time or anything, so they seem a bit pointless. bit of a pointless implementation. That's the only real complaint I can have about this slide, but it's only a couple of boulders anyway, so it's not like it's any big deal. This time, I'll get it. This time I know I have to get it this time, otherwise I shall hang my head in the shame. I shall. Just gotta concentrate. Maybe it's because I'm rambling so much that I'm having such a hard time completing this most wonderful of mini-games. Okay. Round pass. Don't fall in the lava. That sharp turn at the end. That scares me. That really scares me. That sharp turn. Alright, back into the lava cavern, as it were. Jump. 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 I like how they give you a bit of a choice of which platform to go here. It's just nice, I guess. No big deal. Let's try the left path this time if I can. I took the right one before, so why not? And as you can see, yeah, the boulder really just slows me down. It doesn't really have any proper threat. Alright, we're back out again. Back out of the volcano into the lavery river of fire, descending into the ruined jungle. Well, it's not really a ruined jungle. I mean, there are ruins in the jungle. Damn. I should have been more poetic, more eloquent with my speech and descriptions of this most loveliest of environments. So fancy. Make the jump. No! Oh, that jump is so hard. It's so short, and there's such small platforms. I think I might try going around the outer edge, because I think there'll be more jumping room in the outer edge. This is definitely the hardest slide thus far, I must admit. They've definitely cranked up that difficulty dial. They most certainly have. Come on, we can do it. It's not that hard. I just gotta go around the outside next time. I think that'll very much help me. Very much. Jump. 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 With a hop and a skip and a jump. It's brilliant. Uh-huh. Got some lava falls as well. They've put a lot of effort into making this look awesome, I must say. I really must. And that view out there into the skybox, like a valley almost. Ah, oh, come on! Whoa, I think I just fell through the world. To be honest, I think I just kind of fell. What the? What? Guys? I think something's gone catastrophically wrong. Please respawn. Oh gods. Alright, I'll try exiting the challenge and re-entering it, and hopefully that fixes this problem, because yeah, this is kind of terrifying. Alright, there we go, it's fixed. Hooray! Fantastic, let's give this slide another shot then. If I don't get it soon, I'm gonna have to start cutting. What shame, having to cut out portions of the slide. I shan't. This will be my successful attempt. This shall be my successful attempt. But how weird was that glitch, though? It just sort of caused the world to disappear and didn't make it respawn once I went back to the beginning. It was, most weird. Then again, this game, again, it was rushed. There's a fair few glitches still in it. That's not gonna stop this slide from being any less fun, though. No siree. Careful. There we go. I like jumping there. It makes me feel a little more safe, because that path there is very thin to have to get onto. Alright, the lava cavern. Lava cavern's actually one of the easiest parts of this. There's really nothing tough about this. All the platforms are quite large. It's easy to steer, so I don't know. Right. Now this time, as we come around to the bottom, I do want to take the outer path on the left side. So I'm going to be a little bit more meticulous about this. I'm also going to let go of forward, because I think that'll slow me down a little bit, possibly. Is it slower? It's hard to tell. If it is, it's not by much, but anyways. Alright. Left path. I shall endeavor to take it. Alright, hopefully this is easier. It sure as hell looks easier. Oh yeah, that left path was definitely easier. Most definitely. Oh gods, I can't see. I couldn't see lava pits. That's a little bit cheap. The way the camera was positioned there, it was very hard to see what I was doing. Oh well, we'll have to give it another try. Oh, come on, man. Again, falling down there. Okay, we're approaching where I failed last time. Come on. I can nail it. I know what's coming this time, so hopefully I can nail it. Hopefully I'm not spewing hot air, or should I say hot lava. Oh god, it's lots of boulders, lots of boulders. Oh, is that really the end right there? I thought there was a little more inside this temple here at the bottom. Ooh, what's that statue? Oh.
You made it just in time, Spyro.
You made it just in time.
Here, I found a dragonfly on my way down.
Interesting. Of course, it's a blue one.
Hey, it's Sarji.
Sarji, cool name. Why would it not be a red dragonfly? Come on, it's a lava slide. Red for lava.
It seems as if the volcano has stabilized. Wanna try sliding down it again?
Well, not if I'm not gonna get a dragonfly. Anyways, I didn't get a chance to look at that statue inside that temple at the end. Seems a real shame they didn't make better use of that temple. That seems like a very huge room. You could have had like a big platforming challenge in there or something. I don't know, we're just spilling out ideas here. Alright, back in the main level. That really was good fun, that slide, wasn't it? It really, truly was. But now it is time for Ice Breath Challenge. Or Electric Breath Challenge, you know, whatever. Whatever you happen to feel like at the time, game. I really thought it was going to be an Ice Breath Challenge, but okay, guess not. This doesn't look too hard. It looks like I have a fair bit of time as well. That's a little bit underwhelming. I mean, this is the last level of the game. You sort of presume if they're going to put one of these challenges in, it's going to be the hardest one. But, no, this seems like the easiest time challenge I've done in the whole game so far. That's definitely something they should have spent more time on making more challenging. Come on, Sparks, let's see. You complete a challenge and release the dragonfly. Another blue one.
Hey, it's Karen.
Karen? It says Rhett. What? What? Okay, Rhett is Karen. That Rhett confirmed. Rhett is Karen 2K17. that's the name. Anytime I see someone named Rhett from now on, I'll call them Karen and vice versa. That's how it's gonna work. Ice breath that guy. It's like that Russell and Russell Tim dragonfly in Honey Marsh. I've read online, apparently it says there are some versions of the game where it only says Russell and it should be Russell Tim. So I'm guessing that dragonfly is supposed to be called Karen, but nope, it just says Rhett. This is an interesting gimmick. We've got like, I would call them like lava spurts, but they don't really seem to look like lava spurts, as they look like stretchy lava things. Like, it doesn't look like they're bursting out, it looks like they're connected physically to the platform, you know? That's definitely very cool looking. Look at that. That Tiki Head statue, the lava river going past it. Tiki Head statue's reminding me a little bit of Idle Springs from Spyro 2, actually, I must say. And we've got another robot guy. And get that gem. Fantastic. Now, what could be around here? More gems, I guess, but anything else? Any dragonflies? Oh my god! Oh my god! This is beautiful. Look at those lighting effects. Like, my goodness. They're not like completely stupidly sophisticated lighting effects. They just look really nice. You never really see anything like that in Spyro games. That is so cool. Like in this lava chamber, we got this bright red light flowing in. It's sort of orange really, isn't it? Aesthetically, this level is just blowing me away, I must say. Even gameplay wise, it's been pretty damn great too. What with the slide and everything. I feel like it's going to be over way too quick, because we really are bursting through the number of gems this level has. We really are. There's only about 200 left. Which would definitely be a shame. Oh. Hey. I said kill that guy. Thank you. It even looks like we have another challenge. I saw another, little power challenge down there. Which is interesting. No level's had two of those so far, so definitely intriguing they're doing again. Oh, yellow gem. Two yellow gems. And they're both worth 25. That makes me scared. Makes me think this level is going to be over way too quickly once again. Oh, well. Let's see what this guy has to say once I gather up these gems, of course. Oh, or maybe not. Did that gem just fall through the floor? At least I got it.
Gosh darn it. Those blasted R1000s destroyed my lab and ran off with my equipment.
Dr. Kogan. Gosh darn it.
Hello?
Hello.
Oh, hey Spyro. Say, I don't suppose you could help me get my equipment back, could you?
You know, Spyro's had a lot more dialogue with the characters in this level than he has with most of the other levels, to be perfectly frank. And I don't know why Spyro was like, hello. I'm pretty sure he was talking to us. Like, do you seriously not know we were here?
Thanks, Spyro.
those R1000s out there. Say borrowed my equipment.
Borrowed.
All I need you to do is to keep it back.
The way he said borrowed didn't sound sarcastic. At all. Did not sound sarcastic.
Oh, that's all you want me to do. And how exactly do you want me to do that? There's a lava pit out there.
Jeez, Spyro is so rude and sarcastic, but what the hell?
Yes. Well, it just so happens that these scientists here have needed to go on to the lava also. We therefore developed these devices that you can use too. Here, let me turn it on for you.
Looks like it was already on from when I saw it before.
Now all you have to do is pass through this gateway, and you would be able to walk onto the lava without being hurt. However, Spyro, the invulnerability that you have to the lava won't last long. But you can come back and recharge if necessary.
It was definitely a long-winded way.
Now it's time to go kick some Riptock butt.
Yes, of course, Spyro, always raring to kick some Riptock butt. But yeah, that was a very long-winded way of we're still going. What the, there's so many dialogue boxes just to say, you know, use the invulnerability to kill these enemies. Like, I don't know. This is the only time in the game we've had the invulnerability to deadly surfaces, which is a bit of a shame. Would have liked to see it a little more, but hey, whatevs, I guess. How many of these guys are there anyway? There's no number in the corner to tell me, but it looks like I'm just following them along this path here, so nothing too difficult, really. Yeah, there's next ones. Oh, I swear I flamed there, or, you know, iced, whatever you want to say. Hey, mate, how are they even staying frozen on this lava? There we go. I don't know how they're staying frozen. It makes no logical sense, man. Makes no logical sense. Hopefully I can get back in time to recharge if I need to, because I'm not sure where the other guys are. Ooh, there's Dragonfly right there. Interesting, let's catch him. Don't you run away, thank you. A yellow one. It's Mitch! There's a Dragonfly that has my name in this game. Oh my god, I'm blown away. There was not an egg in Spyro 3 that had my name. Now there is a Dragonfly in this game, which has my name. Alright, official favorite level in the game right now, just because of that. No, just kidding. just kidding. But I don't know, this level is definitely very good. It's definitely one of the best ones. Can I flame him, or... There we go. It is not my favorite, just because a Dragonfly in this level has my name, okay? That's not the only reason if it is my favorite level. Oh, what is this? Oh, I was supposed to be picking up these, was I? Okay. I didn't realize. Let's go pick them up real quick, then. Anyway, yeah, that would be pretty vain and egotistical of me if this was my favorite level in the game, just because of that. Hopefully I can find all these vials, or conical flasks they look like. I didn't know I had to pick them up. I thought it was to kill the enemies, didn't even see they were carrying the flasks. I think this is going to be annoying. I really can't see them, and I don't think the draw distance is very good on this either, so this is going to be irritating. Well, here's a couple over here at least. So that's four left, and here's one, another one. I'll have to go back and recharge in a moment. There's another one. And another one. Are they all around here? I feel like I missed at least one other one along the other course of the path. Yeah, I have. I've missed one somewhere. Where, though? Where, oh, where? It's gonna be tricky, I think. Mr. Conical Flask, where are you? Come to Papa. Come to Papa. Oh, what's this? I didn't even see this earlier. I completely missed one of them, apparently. Interesting. There we go, there's the last one. Completely missed this little pathway with those crystals, or are they just beams of light? Kind of look like both. That little tunnel caveway with the things. I don't want to go in that challenge portal, because if I go in there, it might make me have to redo this whole challenge with the flasks. So I'll keep in mind that the challenge portal is here. Is there anything around this corner? No? Wait, I'm just going to quickly check the other corner, just in case. No. Alright, you know, I'm going to run back to the guy, going to get my dragonfly, and then I'll come back here. Yeah, I was like running through this tunnel. I'm like, have I seen this before? I don't think I have. I was right in front of the beginning. What the hell? How did I miss that? I was a fool. Alright, let's talk to the guy. Hopefully get our lovely dragonfly. What's he gonna say?
Great job, Spyro. You found them all. Here, I found this dragonfly under some broken equipment I found in my lab. You can have it.
Lovely. Another blue one, of course.
Hey, it's Jason.
Jason. All right. Let's get to that challenge pool then. Hopefully it's as fun as the lava slide was, but that's definitely a high bar to beat, I must admit. Definitely a high bar. And there it is. Looks like a little temple of its own here. Might be some kind of temple challenge. Maybe a platforming challenge. I would love to see that. I would very much love to see another platforming challenge, though the Thieves' Den one kind of already, you know, blew that out of proportion to a degree that's kind of tough to match for this level, but hey, they could do it.
Welcome.
What's he got to say?
Scary
and ridiculous heights.
If you can climb to the top of the tower, you will prove yourself worthy of the tower's secret treasure. Why a tower exists in the middle of the jungle is a secret hidden away ages ago.
I'm actually shaking my head right now. You know why? Because this is awesome. It is a platforming challenge, and it's a climbing tower challenge, which is really epic. What a way to end the game. You have an epic slide, and now you have an epic tower climb. Holy crap, this level's awesome. This is... wow. Oh my goodness, look at that. That looks epic. It really does. Look at that thing. Oh my... there's spiders on it. Ah, get the creepy spiders away from me. I'm not that much of an arachnophobe, but I'll definitely keep my distance from spiders if I can help it, mate. Oh boy, they're really giving us quite the camera pan, aren't we? Aren't they, rather?
You dare climb that tower up here?
What is with that evil laugh, mate? Aren't you the same guy that was in charge of the slide, Professor Squeak? What is with this guy?
That's the spirit, Spyro. Watch out for falling rocks and blow dart traps. There are some mean-looking spiders up there, too. Just avoid everything and get to the top.
Can do. Can do. Alright, go then. Oh, wait, what? Do we have a time limit? Oh, no, wait, that's a health bar. Oh, I see. We don't even have, like, sparks. We just have a health bar. That's cool. Oh, boy. I don't like that. Is there another way I can go up, please? Help. I really don't like that. Okay, this looks a bit easier. This looks a bit easier. They don't seem to be coming out as fast. Unfortunately, I've already lost quite a lot of health. Oh, jeez, darts coming out that way. I didn't see. Oh no, boulder, run. Run! No, come on! Alright, this is more irritating than I thought it was gonna be. Damn it, I'm dead already! They're not gonna make this easy, are they? They are not gonna make this easy. To be honest, I was expecting like a proper platforming tower challenge, not like a climbing challenge, which disappoints me a little bit. But I don't know, this is still cool. I still like this. Yeah, this time. Oh boy, can we make it? Oh my god, they shoot out boulders so quickly. I don't think it's physically possible to climb that fast. No, look, it's not physically possible. How? Alright, I guess I've got to go up this way now. And I can't see the boulders coming. It's brilliant. Please, yes, I'm past. Okay, now, let's try this way. Go. I don't know how many paths there are to get up this. I hope there's a fair few, though. Oh, boy, no boulders. Stay away from me. Oh, my God. This is scary. Ow, ow, ow. Get on. What the fuck? What? What is the point in having a health bar if you get hit and then fall off to your death immediately? I was trying to grab back onto the ladder. It wouldn't let me. It legit wouldn't let me. So, like, what the hell, game? And are there any platforms to catch me at any point for the duration of this thing? Because, you know, I'd kind of appreciate that. Kind of appreciate it. Let's go past that one. Up. This time I'm just gonna try going past the boulders. Oh god, no. Oh my god, did you see that cycle? Oh my god, I managed to grab back on. Don't even know how I managed to grab back on. Oh my god. This is terrifying. This is actually terrifying. What the hell? Oh, I see. I have to go when the outer ones are shooting. Alright, that makes more sense now. It actually makes some sort of sense. Can I climb up here? Oh, okay, the texture must just be glitched for some reason. Okay. Now, what are these doing? Oh, I see. I can stand between them. That's lovely. I actually have a safe zone where I can, you know, calm down and not be terrified of falling off. That guy's shooting a bowler. Run! Okay. I think we're nearly at the top, actually. That's the top right there. Oh, we got spiders, though. Oh, no, and we've got... Oh, I managed to grab it again. Lucky. We've got bloody darts shooting out again. I didn't even see them. That's terrifying. Oh, God, no! I didn't... Over here. There's a platform. Oh, God, there's a spider. Run. The spiders. They're scary. Scary spiders. Don't let them get near me. Oh, my God. Those things actually look scary. Not even kidding. Look at them. Look at those freaking things. They look terrifying. Can I sneak past this guy? Is it possible? Does he give me an opening? It looks like he gives me an opening. If I stick to the left here, I might be able to sneak around him. Please. Yes! Yes! Dominated! Absolutely dominated. Give me my reward, good sir.
That was terrific, Spyro. I've never seen anyone get up here before.
Yeah, that's right, boy.
Really? Then how did you get up here?
I think he was meaning anyone except himself.
Oh, that. Well, there's a hidden elevator that only I know how to find. But anyway, you'll have to keep it a secret, but there's not really any treasure up here. I never actually thought that anyone could get to the top.
Damn it.
What? So I did all that for nothing?
Well, I guess I should give you something. It's not much. But I found this dragonfly hiding in my secret elevator. Here, you can have it.
Lovely. Another blue one, of course.
Hey, it's Warren.
Warren! Yeah, I'm not sure how big that tower actually was around the edges.
I don't have any more dragonflies to give you, but you can try climbing to the top again if you want. You know, just for fun. You do know what fun is, don't you, Spyro?
Yeah, no thanks. See, I wonder... how many other paths I could have taken up that tower, because I saw a lot of spiders in the opening cutscene, but I only went in that one area that had spiders. I don't know, definitely a replay value sort of thing, I guess. All the various ways you can get to the top and so on, but one way is enough for me for now for this Let's Play, so let's just stop it there, I think.
Okay, this tower has been here for years, and it will be here when you decide to try again.
Yeah, I'm not going to decide to try again. Well, at least not on this playthrough. Maybe when you actually have a dragonfly on offer again, good sir. Maybe then. Alright, here we are. Back in the main level. Not too much left to do, I would imagine. I've only got about 100 gems left, and I'm not sure how many dragonflies I've gotten so far, but I guess at least 6, maybe 7, something like that. I don't know. We'll see. We shall see. I feel like if there is not much left of this level, then it was a little bit short of a level. I don't know, I'd like to see more. There's only 600 gems in level, and I thought maybe it'd pull a Thieves' Den and have lots of 1s and 2s. There actually were a lot of gems, and it's quite a big level, but no, we've had a few 25ers here. I mean, there really hasn't been that many gems, and thus not that big of a level, which is a bit of a shame, but at least it did have one really fun side challenge and another one, which is pretty damn good as well. Oh, look at that, another yellow gem. Ah, it's only worth 10, though, so not too bad, I suppose. Anyways, do we have another, like, power-up challenge here? Oh, yeah, another shield one. Alright, let's talk to this guy. Is he just gonna say kill the enemies, pretty much? Civil.
That bad old thief over there stole something from me. Can you believe that?
No.
He stole a biomolecular hologram projector from me. And if you would kindly retrieve it, I will reward you graciously.
Lovely. With a dragonfly, of course. Anyways, we have gems on the lava this time. That's a change. Gotta gather these up. And, oh my goodness, I'm actually really close to getting all gems in this level. These must all be ones, I guess. Yeah. Definitely all ones. Let's try and catch that thief. Come back here, you little bugger. Oh my god, I don't have much invulnerability left, actually. That's concerning. There's another portal over here. What's this guy got to say? What's he for? Oh. Is this the way I'm supposed to go? I thought there was another way to go back there. Oh. We got another one of these to help me on here. Enemies, these guys. Oh, these guys just have gem. Oh, what? They give me. That was odd. There was. It had a counter in the corner. Was I supposed to do that for a challenge? Because if so, that's a pretty damn short challenge. Anyway, come on, thief. I'm enjoying how we actually have a thief chases level. We've not had enough of these, and the one in Honey Marsh was a little bit dull. Damn it, if I get that filler up there, it means he gets a head start on me. It's irritating. I've got to cut him off. Oh, I'm catching up. catching up to you, mate. Gotcha. What's that done then? Oh, we need to talk to the guy, right? I was thinking it was like the Thief and Onimaster, just like automatically gives me a dragonfly. Nope, I've got to talk to my friend here. Let's go.
Great job, Spyro! I knew you could do it! Here, take this. It's a dragonfly I found in the jungle.
Yeah.
Just fly to red and fly in the jungle.
Hey, it's Bonky!
Bonky! Funny name, that one. And it's another blue one, of course. They're always blue. We know that by this point. Oh, is there nothing in here? Is it really just an empty little temple area? Like, why? What's the point? Why do you even program it in? Decorative purposes, I guess. I guess it's better than nothing. I can appreciate that, I suppose. Alright, looks like this is the way to go then. Talking to this other rat doctor in this area here. I'm just gonna gather up these gems first, though. We are very close to getting all the gems. Very, very close. Alright, let's talk to him.
Spyro, you made it! Great job!
Dr. Egghead. Not even hiding it now. Just their eggheads.
It was no sweat.
As a reward for your heroic efforts, and in the name of good science, please accept this as a reward.
Alright, sweet. Another blue one. Wonky.
Hey, it's Wonky.
We have Bonky and Wonky. I like that. So, this guy isn't the end of level guy, but he just randomly gives me a dragonfly. That's strange. Maybe I did have to kill those three enemies there that had the counter for it. I don't know. Oh, I think I can hear the end of level portal down this elevator. Wherever this elevator actually goes, hopefully the last gems are in this room. That would be lovely. Oh, I definitely see some gems. I see some fives. That's promising. Yep, there's the end of level portal. Got a 5 here, probably a 1 in there. Oh no, a 2. Oh, wait, what? Is that it? Six. I thought there was another gem over there. I swear there was another gem here in the corridor. Right there, it was sitting there. I could swear there was another gem sitting right here. That is weird.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, now it opens for me. Now, I'm guessing I have 600 gems. I'm also guessing I have 9 dragonflies. Oh, I need guy's breath. And that the final dragonfly is the one in the chest over here. So let's go do it. Let's go do it. Come on. I want to see that 10 out of 10. I want to see that level complete. That's what I want to see. Here she is. The chest with the skull on it. Is this our final dragonfly of the game? I think it might well be. Please don't be a blue one. Come on, don't be boring.
Hey, it's Jean-Marc.
No dragonfly appeared. It was invisible. Jean-Marc, well, that's definitely one of the more interesting names of the game. It's French, like Laurent, back in Crop Circle Country. It's still one of my favorite dragonfly names, Laurent. It's just a fun one to say. But apparently that was only our 89th dragonfly. There's another one here. Let's have a look at our atlas. 89. Where's the other one? Look at that, 7,000 out of 7,000. We found every single gem in the entire game. I'm very happy about that. Yeah, 9 out of 10. Alright, let's go down and have a little look. Alright. So, wait, let's just scroll through. Yeah, Thieves Den. Okay, so here we go. Jurassic Jungle. Nice, cool picture there. I like it. Recover lab pieces. Lightning challenge. Locked in a chest. Thief chase. Attack of the cavemen. Inside the temple. On the lava. Lava slide. Power. Oh yeah, neither of the dragonfly challenges here were double ones either. I just realized that. It's like Honey Marsh, there's 8 dragonflies in the main level. But where is that dragonfly? It's the second one, apparently. It's hidden around here somewhere. Apparently, I'm only 95% complete. I guess I have to do the final boss to get the last few percent. Anyway, I'm really not sure what this last dragonfly is. I guess I'm going to have to spend some time looking for it and get back to you guys. What's this all about? Apparently there's some electronic things left over here. I thought I did this challenge. There's the last one. Oh, it's up there. Could this be the last dragonfly? This is very random. These weren't here before. And I swear I did the electric breath challenge with the things, so... Zero. It didn't do anything. Yeah, I guess that was just a glitchy, no reason thing. You know, it could just be the last dragonfly the level I need to talk to this guy for. Dude, why am I stuck? Why am I stuck? Why can't I move? Dude. Stop laughing at me. Why can't I move? I tried going to the cutscene and now it won't. Alright. I'm gonna exit the level. I'm gonna try again. Man, that was irritating, to say the least. Now I've got to re-enter the level, and I've got to talk to the guy. I'll probably get a cutscene now for the final boss or something. Why does it say 6,999? It should say 7,000. What the hell? Wait. Whoa. Was that just some laggy stuff? Or is there a problem? Oh, I'm so confused right now. Let's see what happens when I get back to the home world. Do we get a cutscene? No. Apparently not. Well, let's just go back into the level and try and get that last dragonfly. Now it says 7,000. Alright, what does he have to say?
The cosine of pi multiplied by a star. Yes, that's it!
That's it? He doesn't give us the... Oh my god, where is this dragonfly? Seriously. I think I'm just gonna look it up, to be perfectly honest. I think I might go do that real quick. Okay, so I had a little look on the interwebs, and no, I didn't actually look up how to get the dragonfly itself. I just jogged my memory as to the fact that there was a puzzle in this temple room, which I completely ignored. I just completely forgot about this whole puzzle that Professor Copeland was, like, alluding to and everything. I went in this room and I just completely ignored it. Like, what the hell was wrong with me? I think I just have to flame these little crystal things. Does it do anything? No? Let's try using all our breaths on it. Wait, whoop. Electric breath release. No? Oh, wait, what? Oh, okay, it's working now. Am I supposed to do this in some kind of order? Okay. Oh. Wait, what? What is the correct order? Wait, if I start with the red, let's try the purple. Does that do anything? It only turned the blue off. So I'm guessing if I do it in the wrong order... Okay, green... Then yellow? Oh, is that... No? Oh boy, I don't like this. I don't know which one to start with. Alright, you know what? We're gonna do this by order elimination. So it's not yellow, then green. Is it yellow, then purple? It is not yellow, then purple. Is it yellow, then blue? I don't even know if two of them will stay on at the same time if I have the right order. It's not yellow and blue. Surely there's a hint around here. I must be missing something. Yellow and red. No? What did the guy say again? Did he... I swear he gave me some kind of hint. Let's see. All the elements there. What? Ah, it's nothing to do with anything. Now, oh, wait a minute. I can see. There's diamonds behind here. Yellow... and green? Wait, what? If it doesn't start with yellow, does it start with green? Does doing that do anything? Green, then yellow? Does that do anything? Is it not? No, it's not. Is there other pictures around the room I'm missing? Oh, whoa! There's a dragonfly in there! What the? I didn't even see that! What the? I guess I have to solve the puzzle to get it out. Damn, man, what? I saw a purple diamond up there, I think. Or was it a red one? What order, though? What order do you want me to do this? I'm gonna climb up and get a better look. Oh, I was hoping this would be over nice and quick, but... Damn, man. Alright, there's a purple one up here. Purple, blue, red. Should I start with purple, blue, red, then? Purple. Yeah. Blue. let's just turn that one off. I don't get it. Will they stay on? I don't know if they stay on if I do it in the right order. That's the most confusing part. Ah, this is awful. Start with red, I guess. Blue. And there's a symbol in the middle of the diamond. Does that represent anything? There's not a symbol on that one. Are there symbols on any of the other ones? Does a symbol only appear on the one you're supposed to do next? What's that? I'm not sure what that is, that symbol. I'm not sure what that one is either. Or that one. My god, this is really freaking confusing. What am I supposed to do? Oh! Red, wait. Red and green stayed on. Starting with red, now green stayed on. Oh my god, okay. I figured it out. It's gonna be easy from now on, surely. Because there's only three other colors left it can be. So, red. Looks like I had it right the first time. I just should have kept going and not confused myself and kept on trying all the combinations that are possible. Is that... No, that's not it. Okay. It must be red, green, blue then. Red, green, blue. It's kind of annoying having to run back and forth across the room, but hey, whatever. Red, green, blue. Oh, is it like the value of gems? Like from the first game, the first Spyro. Red, green, blue, yellow, purple. In ascending order. Oh. That's what it's referencing. Oh. Well, maybe not. Maybe it's purple, yellow. I guess it's not referencing anything. I mean, these are the same colors as the colored gems from the Crash Bandicoot games, I guess. The five colored gems. I don't know. They're just the five main colors except orange, really, aren't they? Alright, this has got to be it. It's got to be it. Yes, okay, and then yellow last. Oh, that's why the yellow one makes that electrical sound, because it's the last one that's supposed to activate it to give you the dragonfly, I see. Here we go, the final dragonfly of the entire game. Nice puzzle to end off all dragonflies, and it's a yellow one too, an unusual color. Let's go. Scarlet.
Hey, it's Scarlet.
Shouldn't it be a red dragonfly if it's called Scarlet, not yellow? That doesn't really make any sense. Whatever. Level complete. Tis done. And here we go, exiting the level. What a level that was. As I already said, aesthetically speaking, it probably has to be my favorite level in the game. Challenge-wise, the slide was a lot of fun. The tower could have been better, but was still pretty cool. And I feel like this probably had the most mini-challenges within the main level itself out of any of the levels in the game. You know, we had the electric breath challenge, or the two invulnerability challenge areas, one for the thief and one for those conical flasks. And then we also had that puzzle challenge there at the end I just completely forgot about. There was a lot to it, which I enjoyed. And it wasn't actually too short. This actually take a fair while to run through that level. I know that because I went just a straight run through the level looking for that dragonfly. But yeah, it was a lot of fun. Definitely one of my favorite levels right there. Jurassic Jungle. That's definitely a great one. It is definitely a great one. But with that, if we have a look at our atlas now, we can officially see 7,000 out of 7,000, 90 out of 90. Apparently that last dragonfly did give us the last 5%. We are 100% complete. I guess the last dragonfly is worth 5% because it's the last one, you know, whatever. There we go. Every level of the game, 100% complete. Let's have a look at that dragonfly in Jurassic Jungle. There it is. Gem statue. Everything 100% fully complete. We only have the final boss left. We did not get any cutscene showing us the final boss or anything, which is unusual. Luckily for me, I actually know where the final boss is. It's that little portal thing in sort of the main area of the Dragon Realms. I know this because I've seen a glitch video where you can, like, glitch into the final boss the moment you start the game. You know, you can beat this game in, like, 2 minutes. The glitchiness, man. I don't know. Let's get over there then. Yeah, that thing over there, that little round thing. So what am I supposed to do? Is it open? Oh, it's just open. What activated it? Was it just finishing Jurassic Jungle? What's considered finishing Jurassic Jungle? Like, getting that dragonfly from that guy before the end portal, maybe? Or maybe just once you get 65 Dragonflies, you immediately unlock the final boss and you don't have to play Jurassic Jungle if you don't want to for any percent. I really don't know. I guess I'll have to watch an any percent speedrun of this game. Well, a true any percent speedrun. I noticed glitches into Ripto and beats the game in 2 minutes. But I mean like a no Ripto early any percent run of this game, you know? Anyways, next time we'll be fighting the final boss and finishing this game. I've heard that for 100% you do get a better ending. And there's also another phase, the boss. Apparently Ripto only has two phases if you just go in there any percent. But he has three phases if you go in there with all 7,000 treasure and 9 dragonflies. And when, you know, for beating that third phase, you get an extra special ending. I haven't, like, seen any of these endings or know what this boss is like. I've just read that because I was curious to know what does 100% actually do in this game. I mean, I don't actually know any of the details or anything. Anyways, next time we will be fighting the final boss. I keep going with the final boss. I should say the only boss. That is kind of another disappointing thing about this game. It didn't really have any bosses, does it? Oh well, I was never that big on bosses in Spyro games. Like, they're enjoyable. I wish this game had more of them, but they're not the most important part of the game to me. You know, I feel like having good levels is more important. Anyways, join me next time for when we fight Ripto, the final or first, but first and final boss of this game. So I'll see you then. Until then, this is the Fruity Tangerine 17 signing off.